Ladies and gentlemen, make some noise for the last woman on stage, Miss Katie Stanton.
Hi, everybody. Over the past couple of days, you've heard from some great speakers, and I'm really proud to be here representing Twitter. As you know, the theme of this conference has been turning visions into reality. I'd like to focus on the reality and the real moments. Twitter is a social broadcast network that enables all of us to be in the moment. As we think about some of the historical moments in the world, we think about, you know, where we were, what we saw, what we felt when the first man landed on the moon, when the Berlin Wall fell down, when a single man stood up to the tanks in Tiananmen Square. And we learned about these moments from journalists, from major media organizations, and sometimes there was a little bit of a time delay. Now think about where you were and where you are when major news unfolds today. The plane landing on the Hudson, the Arab Spring, and also the Boston bombing and the manhunt. We learn about these moments from the people who experienced them, from the people who witnessed these moments. We're more connected and we're getting more information than ever before. In these news and everyday moments, Twitter is a platform that is playing a profound role in helping people create and share and extend these experiences. So why Twitter? Well, Twitter is the only platform that is live, that is public and conversational. By live, it's a real-time platform enabling you to connect to anyone, anywhere. It's public. You get information from anyone. There's an asymmetrical relationship where you can follow people from around the world. And it's conversational. There's no other platform that allows you to hear firsthand from brands, from athletes, from clubs, from politicians, and you hear from them and you hear these conversations in rich and unexpected ways. And all of that is possible because Twitter is mobile. 60% of our users access Twitter via a mobile device. We have over 200 million active users, and we see over 3 billion tweets per week. Now that's a lot of content. Today, or recently, we launched a product called Vine, and today we're seeing over 40 million users of Vine. Vine is a short-form video service, and in 6 seconds allows us to hear and see these animations of news and conversations. So with these billions of tweets and comments and pictures and Vines, that represents billions of live moments. So I'm going to share with you a couple of examples of how these moments come to life and how we're connected. Now here's an example of a guy named Nick Walenda. Nick Walenda is a daredevil. He comes from a long line of daredevils, a family. He's a seventh generation daredevil. And in this example, he is going across the Grand Canyon. He's walking about 450 meters across the Grand Canyon. And he's doing so as a stuntman, but also knowing that his great grandfather died doing a similar event. So in this example, as he's walking across the tight wire, you'll see him and then and watch very closely.
Thank you, Jesus, for this beautiful view. How's that dust on there right now?
Oh, it's all right.
Okay. Praise you, God. Praise you, Jesus.
Now, it's a somewhat of a dizzying example as you watch this, right? But in this example, the hashtag SkyWire generated 1 million tweets. And of those tweets, you see people, you know, talking about the courage, and this is a victory for courage and for perseverance, and also for dad jeans. And this is coming a commentary from an ESPN journalist. A comedian, Seth Meyers, jumps into the conversation and says, you know, thank you, Jeansus. So if you're a brand, what do you do? Well, here's an example of Lee Jeans, who who jumped into the conversation. They're prepared and they see this moment where they can participate and they add, you know, Lee jeans, preferred by cowboys, rock stars, and Nick Walenda. This was brilliant. It was contextually relevant and it was real time. So let's talk about some news moments on Twitter. It's fascinating to see how news unfolds on Twitter with breaking news. Last January, there was a helicopter crash in London. And moments after the crash, one of the first tweets was posted, and you see this crash here, and you see this tweet here with the image. A couple minutes later, there's another tweet. And then at 8:13, about 10 minutes after the first tweet and the moment of the crash, you see BBC Radio 5 Live, the first media organization to actually report on what's going on. BBC Breaking News picks it up and then starts live tweeting what's going on. And they're using Twitter to curate and source and verify a lot of the data. Now I'm going to show you this visualization, and you can see all the eyewitness reports, and you see a lot of the commentary going on Twitter. And watch very closely what happens with BBC News. It's going to start to pop up. And what this is representing, as BBC Breakings, that account starts to source the news and check the news, and they're live tweeting this. And it's not a coincidence, because the large majority of BBC journalists, they're active on Twitter, they're sourcing Twitter, and they were there in the moment to help understand what was going on in this big moment. So let's talk about sports. Sports is probably the subject that is most widely discussed around the world, offline and online. And as a result, it's also a big part of the conversation here on Twitter. In fact, the data suggests to us that football, in a European, not an American sense, is a global passion. We see about 47 million football fans on Twitter. And we see that when there are big games and big events, they drive the conversation. So last year during the London Olympics, there was one of the peak moments of conversations in the Super Bowl, the UCL semifinal between Barcelona and Chelsea, and then the Euro 2012 final between Spain and Italy. Those are some very big moments, some of our world records of tweets per second on Twitter. The conversations, the cheers, and in some cases, the heartbreak are felt in every corner of the world. The roar of the crowd isn't limited to the stadium, but it's heard and it's felt worldwide. It's important for brands to be prepared for the moment. You don't know who will win, you don't know what the big play will be, but what you do know is that everybody's watching and you have to be there. So here's a great example of Adidas, who is there watching the games, and as a heavy tweeter in there, they go on and they start to jump in the conversation and they celebrate Bayern's win as a sponsor of Bastian Schweinsteiger. So they did a really good job of being part of the conversation and adding contextually relevant content. Now this game generated 6 million tweets, which you can look at as brands, as 6 million opportunities to connect with your audience and with your consumers. Now, as a brand, you might think, well, I'm not a sponsor, I'm not, you know, I don't have broadcaster rights, I'm not really sure how I can actually connect into this conversation. But here's an example from Heineken Brazil, who was also watching the game, and then they came up with this really clever vine. So broadcast moments. The water cooler used to be the place where we would go the next day at work and talk about your favorite show and what happened the night before. But more and more, what we're seeing is that that conversation is turned to Twitter and it's being done in real time. In fact, we're seeing 95% of the public conversation is all happening on Twitter. We see 66% of primary mobile users on Twitter watching TV with Twitter. And then we see 40% of the traffic on Twitter at very key moments, all about television. We see this around the world, and we see that many of our broadcasting partners are integrating Twitter into various types of programming, be it sports, be it news, be it reality TV. Here in Germany, we're seeing a lot of great adoption, and leading the way, ZDF and ProSieben and Sky TV. So we're excited to see a lot of the integrations happening at a global level and then at local levels. Political moments. 30% of world leaders are active on Twitter. They're on Twitter to be able to engage with constituents, engage with one another, and then engage with their opponents. Now, this example from the UK was really interesting. The UK government announced that their campaign for their new budget was called Aspiration Nation. And the opposition leader, Ed Miliband, he took to Twitter and he took to Parliament a conversation and tried to take over that campaign with his own campaign slogan called Downgraded Chancellor. So in this example, I'm going to show you a short clip of the conversations. In white, you'll see the hashtag, all the tweets that had hashtag downgraded chancellor. And in blue, you'll see the tweets that had Aspiration Nation.
Today, Mr. Deputy Speaker, the Chancellor joined Twitter. He could have got it all into 140 characters. Growth down, borrowing up, families hit, and millionaires laughing all the way to the bank. Hashtag downgraded chancellor. Mr. Deputy Speaker, more of the same is not the answer to the problems of the last 3 years.
You can always count on these UK politicians for really animated debates. Now, Germany is going through a very exciting time now with the election in just 3 days. And I think it was about 10 days ago that there was the TV duel between Angela Merkel and Peer Steinbrück. And what was fascinating there is, you know, what we've seen all around the world, and of course here in Germany, is that the conversation continues and unfolds in real time on Twitter. So you see on the the TV duel, you see the number of tweets and the number of conversations people are having. And what was really neat here, what we saw, is that this was the most talked about event on Twitter in Germany to date. So musical moments. So another key interest on Twitter is music. We see that 4 of the top 5 most followed accounts on Twitter are musicians. We see that 1 in 2 new users follow at least one musician. And then 44 million users alone follow Justin Bieber. Now, fans of all genres flock to Twitter to be able to discover new music, to get the latest news on their favorite artist, and to share in their love of music. But I want to share one example from MTV that was really smart about capitalizing on this passion. So they had a call to action that was very simple and very elegant. And they asked their users, tweet us, hashtag MTVHottest, and let us know who are your favorite artists, and we'll display them on there. So in this visualization, you can see the many tweets for One Direction and Justin Bieber and Nicki Minaj, but you can see sort of the global impact. And what was great about this for MTV is that this generated about 166 million tweets and ended up driving their biggest day ever in terms of impressions on MTV Europe. So they were really smart about tapping into the passion of their users. So lastly, you know, I talked about Twitter being a platform for global events and sporting events and these widely shared experiences, but it's also something that can be felt individually and personally. For example, American author Joyce Carol Oates explains that Twitter makes of loneliness something rich and unexpected, but you must choose your travel companions wisely, with care. German politician and federal minister Peter Altmaier tweets that the added value of Twitter is not the number of followers, but the quality of the dialogue, if you're open for it. This is all really good advice. For me personally, a few weeks ago, I was enjoying a private moment in Paris, and I tweeted this photo of the Eiffel Tower sunset. One of the first tweets that I received was from my friend and colleague, Amac, who said I should stop gloating and bragging, which was probably fair. But then I received another tweet from somebody I didn't know who commented on the vision and the reality that I was sharing. And his Twitter handle is @JacksWork, and his profile page says, share what you have seen, be sent what you inspire. He then asked if he could use my tweet and then turn my photo into art and sent it to me. It was one of those rich and unexpected moments for me personally that reminded me to stop and to enjoy being in the moment. Twitter is a reflection of our individual and our shared moments and offers all of us, including brands, an opportunity to connect, to engage, and to act. In short, it allows us to be in the moment. Thank you.